There is an awesome and relatively new Windows repair feature that most people have not heard of, and it allows you to basically repair any form of Windows corruption with Windows itself without having to nuke your entire installation and like reformat or anything. The feature is called Fix Problems Using Windows Update, and it's basically a built-in feature of a more complicated process that I have discussed in a previous video talking about fixing Windows corruption. And in that one, I described the whole process of doing an in-place repair upgrade. Now, I'll show you this new feature with this new process in a second. It's a lot simpler. And like the documentation says, it will reinstall the current version of Windows, but preserves all your apps, settings, and files with no need to reinstall everything. That's a big difference. If you do like reset this PC, it might keep your files, but it'll erase all your apps that you have to reinstall. That is not the case here. Now, if you are having an issue with Windows itself, my other video is still a really good starting point for trying other stuff before you go through this. There's not much to lose with this new process, but you might still want to try other stuff first. And then also in that other video, like I showed previously, what you would have to do this install repair upgrade is download the Windows Media Creation tool, and then it would create like an ISO file that you would mount and then run with specific options. It worked, but it was kind of a pain. And then what it would do is basically upgrade your version of Windows to the same version, effectively just reinstalling over itself, but keeping all the files and stuff like a regular upgrade would do from a previous older version of Windows. Now, apparently this feature was released into the regular general release version of Windows in early 2024. So it's been around for a while, but a lot of people probably just don't know about it. And specifically, it's available in Windows 11 version 22H2 and newer versions. So even if you have 22H2, which was released in 2022, that still got a retroactive update that added this feature in 2024. And of course, if you have 23H2 and 24H2, same thing. However, it is not in Windows 10. You would still have to go through the manual process that I described for Windows 10. So we can go through the process, and specifically you'll find this feature in the settings and then system, recovery, and then again, fix problems using Windows Update. And you start the process by clicking reinstall now. Before I show you that though, something else that's awesome is today's sponsor, Aura. You see, there's a ton of sketchy data brokers out there who collect and sell your information to scammers, spammers, and anyone else who may want to target you. I'm talking your full name, email, home address, health records, your relatives, it's all out there. But that's where Aura comes in. For example, it can show me which data brokers are selling my info and automatically submit opt-out requests for me. Cleaning up this info not only helps me reduce the amount of spam coming my way, but protects me from hackers who might leverage this info to try and access my accounts or even do personalized phishing attacks. I was even surprised when it showed me that the collected public info out there even included what kind of car I drive. But Aura also has a ton of other features, such as antivirus, a VPN, password management, parental controls, identity theft insurance, all in one place, instead of needing a bunch of separate apps. Even if you already have one or two of these tools, you could still be leaving doors open to bad actors, but Aura is always on, so you can have peace of mind and focus on the important stuff. To get started, you can go to aura.com/theojo to start your 2-week free trial. Link is also in the description. And with all that being said, let's continue. So, like I said, to start the process, all you do is click the Reinstall Now button. You'll see this thing pop up, which just shows information about what it does. And it says, if a repair solution is available, we'll attempt to fix system component corruption by reinstalling the current version of Windows. Your app's documented settings will be preserved. I'm not super sure what it means by if a repair solution is available. It seems to just reinstall regardless. However, after you do initiate the download, it does say that it's downloading the repair version, so maybe it's just talking about that. Anyway, it will say downloading, and at some point it will say installing, though this is not the full installation process because it does other stuff to install beyond 100%. When it does reach 100%, if you had selected to automatically restart in that initial window, it will prompt you for a restart and then do so multiple times, just like it would with the main upgrade process. So it'll say working on updates, restart, all that stuff. And then finally, when it's done and you go to log in for the first time after that, it will say the usual getting things ready for you screen. And then after that, you're back into Windows. Now, this looks empty, but it was just an empty virtual machine before, so it's not like it removed anything. If there was any applications installed, they would still be there along with the settings and stuff for the most part. Though, I guess there might be some settings somewhere that might have been reset to the default, or there might be some registry tweaks, for example. Like, I had edited the registry option to make the Windows rounded, which is actually not default in a virtual machine for whatever reason. But after doing this in-place repair install, it's back to being the default square. So it did reset that registry tweak. However, the start menu remained like I had it, where I had unpinned and uninstalled a bunch of the bloatware placeholder shortcuts that were there. And you could see it also kept the taskbar settings, where I had disabled the shortcuts for a few of these features here. It kept that. So really, it's only going to be minor stuff that gets reset to default, if anything. I definitely think this is an awesome, welcome feature that this is actually built into Windows now. You don't have to go through the hassle of downloading the ISO and making sure that it's the same version that you're running and all that. And for the most part, this will solve any corruption with Windows itself. Of course, if an app is causing a problem or it's a corrupted Windows profile, that probably won't be fixed here. But a lot of times, just doing a repair install will fix a lot of issues. Of course, that does not mean that you should just go do it if you don't have a reason to. You should always make sure you have a reason to, and there's other stuff you can try, like I mentioned in my other video, but still, it's an option. I'd be curious if you guys are going to use this feature. Maybe it's just what you needed and you just didn't know about it. Let me know down in the comments. Thanks again to Aura for sponsoring the video. If you want to protect your data and take advantage of all the other features it has, go to aura.com/theojo for a 2-week free trial. Link in the description. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is, if you were ever wondering what that "there is a problem with this USB device" means, that notification, I explain it in excruciating detail in this video right here you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.